Heralded by cheers came the arrival of the royal party. The king was welcomed by Lord Burleigh, and later members of the International Committee were presented. The stage was set and the parade began, headed, according to custom, by Greece, the ancient home of the games. Past the royal box, the standards dipped in salute as team followed team. Australia received her full share of the applause, as did every other member of the British Commonwealth of Nations. Czechoslovakia also had a true Olympic welcome from 80,000 spectators. France, and another wave of applause from an audience drawn from every part of the world. The Shah of Persia looked on as the crowd greeted the Dominion of India, followed by the team from Iran itself. Rising greetings were also given to our friends and allies from Holland. New Zealand, one of the smaller teams who received specially warm applause. Norway, typical of the large and powerful contingents from Scandinavia. And here's another Dominion group who'll never forget their reception. Sweden, too, found many compatriots to cheer them on their way. For nearly an hour, the march went on, not forgetting the massed ranks of the USA, immaculate in blue and white. Lastly, as hosts came the British team, their fine bearing and smart uniforms getting the welcome they deserved. Fifty-eight nations were now assembled, and His Majesty declared open the London Games.
I proclaim open the Olympic Games of London, celebrating as the 14th Olympiad of the modern era.
And now, with a rush of wings, thousands of pigeons circled the arena before carrying to many lands the message that the games had begun. Outside the stadium, a salute of 21 guns echoed the proclamation. So, to the climax, the arrival of the Olympic flame. Last of the long chain of runners who carried the flame from Greece, the torchbearer's identity had been kept secret until this moment. Now, the mystery was ended, as 22-year-old John Mark, personifying the athletic youth of Britain, kindled the sacred flame. And now to the moment of dedication as Wing Commander Donald Finlay takes the Olympic oath.
We swear that we will take part in the Olympic Games in loyal competition, respecting the regulations which govern them, and desirous of participating in them in the true spirit of sportsmanship, for the honor of our country and for the glory of sport.
And so, with the words still lingering in their hearts, a mighty company prepared to carry the Olympic ideals through every chapter of the London Games. The following day and the opening of the track and field events. First, the qualifying rounds of the high jump, with excitement mounting as the finals were reached. Here's the American Stanich, who tied for third place with another member of the U.S. team. Paulsen of Norway came second. And now, Winter of Australia with the winning jump of 6 feet, 6 inches. Throwing the discus provided plenty of fine studies in action. Here's Signorina Gentile of Italy, who came second with a distance of 135 feet, 1 inch. Miss Markinkiewicz of Poland came fourth. And here's Mademoiselle Ostermeyer of France, the winner, with 137 feet, 6 and a half inches. Heat one of the 400 meters hurdles semi-finals. A hard fight with Ceylon, America and Sweden competing for the honors. Larsen of Sweden, number 128, soon went to the front and stayed there, creating a new Olympic record of 51.9 seconds. Heat two of the same event, and now Cochran of the USA was the destined winner. Missoni of Italy and Crow of France were close behind, but it was Cochran all the way. And again, it's a record with the identical time of 51.9 seconds. Greatest event of this first day was the 10,000 meters, a stern test of endurance under a scorching sun. In slow motion, we see three of the early leaders, Ram John of Trinidad, and two British runners, McCook and Cox. Soon, all eyes were on Zatopek, the great Czech runner, who came up strongly in the 10th lap. Before long, he went to the front, lapping runner after runner as the crowd went wild. Battling on, Zatopek kept up a killing pace, a study in grim determination. Up to the finish, and Zatopek wins in 29 minutes, 59.6 seconds. Yet another Olympic record achieved in truly heroic style.